Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, semua dah install plugin tadi tak?
Dah.
Dah eh? Dah buka Ryan, bila buka Grasshopper dah keluar tak Ladybug kat atas? Dekat dia punya tab tu. Cuba sama-sama buka dulu satu file Rhino and then buka satu file Grasshopper and then check dekat tab Grasshopper tu dia akan ada dia akan keluar dekat dia punya menu atas tu Ladybug.
Ada honeybee dengan ladybug.
Ah, okay. So kalau dah ada honeybee yang ladybug tu maknanya dah insyaAllah dah ada. Okay, so kita untuk hari ni suatu day kita akan work with something else pula. As for today, dia akan more lebih kepada parametric form making. And then kita akan connect to environmental aspect sikit. And then kalau sempat, kita akan try apply facade yang kita dah buat hari tu. Kita akan apply pada form parametric form yang kita akan buat pada hari ni. So kita akan start fresh hari ni. So far since last class, ada korang dah explore lebih tak? From last definition, Grasshopper definition tu. Dah ada start yang buat different scale ke ataupun different behavior ke? Dah ada yang lain tak? Okay, masing-masing dah buka?
Dah, proceed.
Okay, first of all aku akan tunjuk dulu apa kita punya outcome for today. This is kita punya final outcome kalau sempat. Okay. This is a form yang aku dah create untuk kita punya class today. If you guys boleh nampak, it's a parametrically rotate in terms of dia punya floors untuk create dia punya rotating effect for the whole building. And kita akan model the shape to be towards a more high rise punya type so that kita dapat lebih lagi exposure in terms of the use of facade itself. Sebab kalau building kecil and then kita nak buat facade macam tak berapa best lah kan. So for this exercise kita akan guna more or less macam typical high rise building height. And then kalau you guys tengok, this is dia punya, kita nanti later kita boleh tukar dia punya height and dia punya floor area, dia punya rotation. At the same time, kita boleh tukar dia punya rotation. Okay, kita nak rotate up to 180 degrees. And then dia boleh rotate to 180 degrees. Tapi the color yang you guys nampak kat sini is a analysis on surface radiation. Where kalau nampak all the red, mana yang color merah ni, all the red parts ni, all the red panels ni indicate yang kawasan yang merah tu akan terima lagi banyak surface radiation compared to the blue ones. And apa dia punya significance to this, to the parametric building ni, parametric system ni is that kita akan create a system yang facade tu boleh react, boleh scale according to the surface radiation on the building surface tu. Lagi banyak surface radiation tu, so dia akan project a certain behavior of the facade. Macam tadi itulah, macam dia closer to the sun, dia akan lagi panjang dia punya protrusion. Tapi in this case kita akan gunakan dia punya terms of analysis dia is a surface radiation. Surface radiation ni one of the things yang Ladybug is very popular tu. Dia macam one of the basic analysis yang you guys boleh buat. But there are so much more lagi lepas ni. There are so much more untuk explore lagi in for Ladybug and Honeybee ni. Tapi as for starting, kita akan guna these types of analysis. I hope you guys boleh catch up sebab hari ni I would go a bit tak adalah faster. I assume you guys dah faham lebih sikit so that kita akan model cepat sikit so that kita boleh explain lebih on the analysis part. Okay, everyone dah ready masing-masing? Okay, kita akan start dengan the form itself. Kita akan create the form. Okay, first sekali yang you guys have to do, kita akan start with polygon. Double click on the canvas and then type polygon macam hari tu. Okay, setkan your polygon to be square, tekan 4 and then click connect to S. Maksudnya dia akan jadi S untuk ada 4 sides, dia akan jadi square. Let's say for R is radius, letak dalam 30 meter radius. Okay. And then RF, RF ni dia punya fillet radius, kita letak 1. So that dia, bila dia ada fillet radius ni, surface of the building nanti dia akan generate S1, dia takkan jadi S4. Macam itu kita akan ada 4 sides kan, yang berbeza yang kita kena deconstruct. Tapi at this time, kalau bila kita ada fillet, dia dah bulatkan dia punya edges tu. Bila dia naik jadi surface, dia akan jadi S1. So bila S1 tu, dia akan lagi memudahkan kita untuk apply the facade later. Okay, sekarang ni apa yang kita akan buat is kita akan copy all the same polygon ni untuk jadikan floor upstairs. Untuk jadikan supaya dia makin tinggi, makin tinggi, makin tinggi. So apa yang you guys have to do is ambil component move, M-O-V-E, move, and then connectkan P pada G. Okay, so dia dah move one step. Tapi kita nak move dia lagi jauh sebab kita nak go macam a tower height. So let's say, and then the component yang kita akan guna is tekan this one, nama dia series. S-E-R-I-E-S. Series. Okay. Bila kita nak move, kita still need Z punya unit. So then double click, tekan Z, unit Z, and then connect to T, and then S ni connect to the punya factor of Z. So kan dia akan nampak dia akan lagi banyak. And then kalau nampak dekat S punya series tu, the first number of the series kat S, just tekan for now is 0. And then connect to S. Okay, the next one ni N ni, kita akan consider benda ni as floor to floor height. So let's say lah floor to floor height biasa is 4 meter. So just tekan 4. Click and then connect to N. And then C ni is the punya total height. Kira in this case building height. Let's say lah you guys letak, in this case 40 meter eh. So maknanya ada 10 tingkat building ni. Then click to see. Okay, so sekarang kita dah ada a collection of curves. Of floor plans lah, consider macam floor plans. A floor area yang dia punya total height is 40 meter and dia punya floor to floor is 4 meter. Okay, sampai situ. Okay, now kita akan try to jadikan dia as a form. Sekarang ni dia still macam lines and lines of two floors and floors and floors and floors. So kita nak dijadikan dia as form sekarang ni. One of the things yang we can do, yang kita boleh manipulate in terms of floor plans ni, is dia punya scale. Maksudnya kalau tengok building kan, maksudnya dia punya scale of the floor plan. Maksudnya this floor plan tu dia boleh kecil dekat bawah, besar dekat tengah, kecil dekat atas. Or at the same time, dia boleh besar kat bawah, kecil kat tengah and kecil balik kat bawah. This kind of thing is a parametric behavior yang you guys boleh control. Maksudnya yang you guys boleh optimizekan lagi. Tapi in this case, kita akan just model dia supaya kita just dapat a surface yang kita rasa best, kita rasa nampak lawa. Tapi be reminded that this factor, this behavior sekarang ni, dia boleh kita boleh optimizekan untuk to get the best performance in terms of dia punya analysis later. Tapi in this case kita just akan modelkan dia sahaja. So now you guys, I want you guys to double click on the canvas and then type scale. Okay, then biar dulu situ. And then type dekat canvas area. And then ambil this one, area, and then connectkan G yang move tadi to the area. Okay, area ni kita akan dapat all the areas of setiap floor plan ni, setiap curve ni kita akan dapat dia punya area. Tapi apa yang kita nak yang paling penting sekarang is dia punya curve, dia punya centroid, which is dia punya central area, central point. So kita dah ada scale tadi, kita dah letak scale. I want you guys to sambungkan G, geometri ni kepada G yang dekat scale. And then kita akan ambil C daripada area tadi, centroid, and then connect pada C. Okay, now you guys boleh offkan dekat move, boleh off, offkan preview dia, and area ni right click, offkan preview dia. Boleh dapat?
Boleh.
Boleh eh? Okay eh? Still following eh? Kalau cepat sangat bagi tahu tau. Don't worry. Just bagi tahu kalau tercepat sangat. Okay.
Boleh.
Okay. So sekarang kita dah ada scale. Okay. Just for experimental purpose, just type F ni kan is factor kan? Factor of the scale. Cubakan factorkan dia as 1.5. And then klikkan pada F. Connect pada F. And then cuba play with the slider of F tu. So nampak tak? Dia akan change dia punya area of floor tu tadi. This is the original. This is the original yang tadi, yang tengah tu original. Yang luar tu is kita punya yang dah scale. Tapi apa yang kita nak buat sekarang is kita nak scale each floor tu. Each floor of the curve tu, kita nak scalekan dia to a different scale. Maksudnya floor yang belah bawah, scale kecil. Floor atas, kecil, makin besar. And then kecil balik. So that dia create form yang macam ni. So dia create the rotation punya element tu. But tak semua rotate dalam angle yang sama. Dia ada satu range, and then semua akan rotate differently. Sikit. This is just one type of rotation yang you guys boleh model in Grasshopper lah. This is one of the very very popular and very common lah. Dia ada banyak lagi type, tapi as for this class, kita akan do this. Okay, apa yang kita perlukan sekarang is kita perlu evaluate dia punya all the centroids tu punya I want you guys untuk type deconstruct. Tapi nampak ni ada satu komponen nama dia deconstruct, and then ada x, y, z. And then click this one. And then letak bawah scale ni. And then ambil C centroid yang tadi, yang from area tadi. And then connect pada P. Apa yang komponen ni buat is dia akan make sure dia akan translate points ni tadi into dia punya specific coordinates. Maksudnya dia ada X coordinates, Y coordinates and Z coordinates. So apa yang kita perlukan sekarang is Z, sebab kita nak tahu dia punya height of dia punya total height tu kan, of dia punya each point of the floor plan. So okay, sekarang ni tekan double click on the canvas and then tekan point. And then sambungkan Z. Sorry, salah. No need for that. Okay, sekarang ni kalau tengok dekat view, dekat Z, tekan double click, tekan panel. And then connectkan Z pada panel. Okay, kalau nampak, this is height per floor tu. Kalau nampak, first floor 0, start from 0, first floor 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24 and so on lah. Sampai last sekali is 156, which is kita punya total height tadi, 40. I'm sorry. It's not 40 meter. It's not tower height. It's 40 kali of the 4 meters. Maksudnya total height sekarang is 160 meters. I'm sorry, silap eh. I hope you guys boleh understand. Again, kalau tengok tadi from panel, connect to the Z. Last kali kalau tengok is 156. So that's dia punya total height of the floor sekarang. Okay, and then apa yang kita akan buat, kita akan create a range of scale by scaling dia punya floor plan tu in kita punya in a better way, in a macam way yang lagi lawa, so that dia punya form dia lebih dynamics. Apa yang I want you guys to do is type remap, macam hari tu is component remap numbers. And then tekan bounds, B-O-U-N-D. And then tekan bounds. And then connectkan Z to the N, to the minimum and max ni. And then I ni to the S and Z to the V. V ni is dia punya list tadilah, value yang kita nak remap tu. So kita nak remapkan the value of Z tu so that dia boleh range, dia boleh range from to a different scales. Okay. In order untuk kita manipulate dia punya, in order untuk kita manipulate dia punya range of areas tu lagi senang, kita akan guna this component. Nama component ni is, sorry dah eh, graph mapper. Right click, double click on the canvas and type graph mapper. This one. Okay, dapat. Okay, from the graph mapper tu, what I want you guys to do is klikkan, connectkan R to the graph mapper. Tapi sekarang ni dia tak jadi apa-apa lagi. Apa yang I want you guys to do is right click on the graph mapper and then pergi dekat graph types and then pergi to, let's say pergi pada Gaussians. Bukan Gaussian. Again, right click graph types, pergi pada Bezier. Okay, now kita akan dapat this type of graph. Semua dapat ya? Eh? Okay, bila graph ni, kita boleh play dia along lah. Kita boleh play along dengan dia. If you guys understand mathematics more, you guys akan lebih faham on the use of graph ni lah. As for myself, I don't understand it that much on the use of this graph. Cuma it's fun to see macam mana by changing this graph, dia boleh, by playing with this graph, dia boleh change dia punya behavior of the scale. This is the final product, nanti I'll show you first. Okay, kalau nampak this is the floor plan yang I dah rotate kan. Tapi let's say lah, if I change this graph, I pusingkan graph ni. Okay, let's say lah kalau you tengok, I change this graph. Okay, nampak? This part is where kita boleh, as a form making punya process, kita boleh play with it. Tapi at the same time, ada juga tools yang boleh optimizekan benda ni to be sustainable. Maksudnya to act towards your sustainable analysis. This is the function of this graph ni lah, so that kita boleh play along dengan dia punya signs and curves tu. Boleh? Sekarang ni so far still with me?
Boleh.
Okay. And then from this graph, I want you guys to ambil remap and bounce ni. Just right control C then just select dia dua ni. And then tekan control C and then control V. Just copy and paste. Okay. And then kita akan connect this graph punya end to the V. And then connect this graph pada end yang minimum and maximum ni. Kita nak remapkan the value of curve kat sini, the value of sine and kat sini untuk jadikan, untuk to remap to kita punya scale of floor plans. Next is construct. Double click and then tekan construct. Construct domain. And then klikkan I to the T. And then A and B ni is going to be your factor of floor plan. First factor, let's say lah you guys nak start dengan 1.0. Maksudnya dia tak ada, dia first factor tu dia takkan lagi kecil, dia takkan lagi besar. Maksudnya dia betul-betul 1-to-1 size. Tapi kita nak scalekan dia yang bahagian paling besar. Let's say I want you guys to inputkan 1.5. Maksudnya bahagian tower ni yang paling besar akan jadi 1.5 bigger daripada dia punya original floor plan.
Sorry, what's the last one?
Which one?
That one.
This one, construct domain.
Construct domain. Okay.
And then you get you inputkan 1.0 and 1.5.
Oh, okay.
Okay, dapat eh?
Thank you.
Okay. Sekarang ni kalau tengok dekat R, kita dah ada remap value of the floor plan tu tau. Kalau tengok dekat sini, apa-apa yang you guys nak viewkan dia punya info, just tekan panel and then connectkan dia punya result to the panel and then panel ni akan keluarkan result apa yang kita perlu. So kalau nampak macam I just said just now, The first one tu dia akan start with one. Sebab dia, dia kita dah startkan dia punya range dia from one. And then kalau tengok sampai bawah sekali, dia akan back to one balik sebab this behavior ni dia react to this graph punya style. Let's say lah, if I change the graph types to linear. Linear tu maksudnya dia memang betul-betul start, dia akan scale from 1 betul-betul sampai up to 1.5. Tadi tu dia akan scale from 1 to 1 and then dekat tengah dia pergi 1.5 and then dia pergi turun balik, pergi 1. Sekarang ni kalau dia scalekan from 1, kalau tengok dekat start dia akan jadi 1 and then bawah sekali dia akan jadi 1.5. Maksudnya can you imagine dia punya shape of the floor tu dia akan jadi macam mana? Dia akan jadi betul-betul from dari kecil and then ke besar. Okay, how you guys boleh achieve benda tu is by connecting R ni pada scale factor tadi. Tadi kan kita ada letak 1.5 tadi kan scale ni. Okay, just delete 1.5 ni and then connectkan R pada F. And then previewkan scale.
Okay, dapat.
Okay. Okay, at this stage, cuba korang play around dengan graph ni. Let's say lah kalau I change it to this way, dia akan jadi menurun. Maksudnya belah bawah, dia akan scale besar, belah atas dia akan scale kecil. The way you can see it is, benda tu akan ditranslated directly dekat panel ni. Kalau nampak, tadi awal ni is 1 kan, sekarang ni dah jadi 1.5 and bawah ni dah jadi 1. Tapi kalau you guys nak play with a form yang lagi lain, yang lagi dynamics and ada lagi banyak curve, janganlah ambil linear sebab linear memang kita tahu linear, macam linear graph, dia akan with the increase of x, the increase of y kan. Tapi let's say lah kita play with, selalunya kita akan play with yang Bezier ni. Bezier ni is one of the yang paling, I would say yang paling, paling apa ya, playing fluid sikit lah. Kita boleh macam, kita boleh play along banyak sikit. If you guys understand mathematics, dia akan lagi best lah. For me, for myself, I don't understand it as much. Tapi kalau you guys really understand it, sebenarnya dia, this is technically mathematics lah on this graph kan. Okay, kalau play along with this, dia akan jadi macam mana. This is totally on your decision lah, macam mana, maksudnya nak buat form ni macam mana in you guys punya project lah. Let's say later kalau you guys nak do something like this. Tapi macam I just said tadi, this behavior pun kita boleh optimize to be sustainable. Tapi that would be a bit lagi advanced. Let's say lah for the purpose of sebab kita nak buat fasad kan. So one thing yang kita akan cuba elak is self-shading buildings. Sebab kalau dah ada self-shading buildings, kita buat pun lagi nak buat fasad. So kita, the fact yang kita nak buat fasad tu is because kita nak protect the building from the sun. So let's say lah kita akan create the most vulnerable shape ever. Shape yang macam yang sangat vulnerable to the sun. Let's say lah this shape. Technically dia takkan ada self shaded sebab in a way it's high rise to be self shaded is very hard lah sebab dia akan involve a lot of stagging. Tapi for a normal shape yang macam ni dia takkan self shaded, hence dia akan justify the needs for you guys untuk buat the facade later lah. So that is just a little bit of real sikit on this. Tapi that's one of the reasoning yang you guys have to understand bila buat this exercise on recursive lah. So apa yang back to grasshopper, apa yang kita akan buat lepas ni, kita akan try rotate each curve ni. I would call this all this line ni is one curve and a curve ni to a different rotation. And then baru kita boleh connect dia jadi a surface. Okay, what I want you guys to do right now is copy tiga benda ni, bounce, construct domain and remap. Copy lagi sekali, Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Okay, but this time ambil from the deconstruct yang Z point ni tadi. Ambil Z point ni and then connect to the V yang baru ni, pada remap yang baru. And then the same thing, Z ni connect to the minimum and maximum. Okay, and then kita akan create a new range. Range yang this time, yang untuk kali ni, range ni is untuk dia punya rotation value. So let's say kita start dengan rotation value dia is 0, maknanya the first floor plan tu dia akan start with 0 and then click pada A. And then the next one is let's say lah 180 degrees. 180 and then connect pada B. Okay, sekarang ni kita dah create satu range of numbers yang akan represent the rotation factor of kita punya each floor plan ni. Okay, now ambil on the canvas, tekan rotate. And then daripada G ni tadi, daripada scale ni tadi, collect connect dia punya geometry to the geometry yang dekat rotate. And then dia punya P, dia punya point dia, points of rotation tu, you guys ambil dari center tadi, center yang from before. So kita still use the same center, so kita tak perlu nak establish a new center. So building center dia still sama. And then A ni, you guys right click and then tekan degrees. In order untuk change dia punya rotation dia to a degrees punya value. Okay, now kita dah ada rotation value tadi from R yang dah remap number ni. Okay, you guys just have to connect R to the A. Okay, sekarang dia akan jadi shape based on apa yang you guys punya curve tadi. Based on you guys punya graph, dia akan jadi shape apa yang korang nak. Okay, dapat? At this stage, korang boleh play along dengan korang punya degrees. Okay, macam tadi kan? Let's say I change the degrees tadi 180. Okay, cuba play the slider ni. Sampailah 360, dia akan, maksudnya bila dia sampai 360 tu, maksudnya dari first floor plan sampai ke atas tu, dia dah go for 360 degrees rotation. Maksud, kalau tengok dia punya, kalau you guys nak tengok dia punya data, tekan panel and then view on the R. Kalau tengok 0, dari first kali 0 to 370, tu dah 370 tu dah too much lah. Basically sampai, maksudnya dia dah lebih 360 lah, which basically boleh. Tapi in this case, kita akan just set to 180. Okay, be reminded that this stage pun, it can be optimized untuk for the sustainable analysis. Maksudnya, imagine a building yang you can justify berapa banyak rotation building tu in order for the building to be optimized for the surface radiation. In this case, kita just assume kita and just kita just create a number of degrees yang dia nak rotate, tapi kita tak ada apa-apa any justification on dia punya reasoning lagi. Tapi kalau you guys explore lagi more macam mana kita nak optimizekan the rotation ni, macam mana kita nak optimize the shape of the building through the rotation of the floor plans, then that would be even a better example lah for this stage. And then bila you guys dah siap ni, so I just change to 90 degrees. And then kita akan guna loft. Kita akan jadikan dia a surface. Tekan loft, L-O-F-T. And then from the G, tekan pada C. Okay, now dia dah jadi surface. Okay, jadi tak?
Jadi.
Okay, from daripada loft ni, you guys right click dekat O, pergi dekat loft option, loft options. And then pergi dekat normal ni, pergi dekat uniform. And then commit changes. Okay, basically dia tak nampak apa-apa, tapi dia akan make so much difference because dia akan make sure lofting process between each curve tu dia akan uniformly sama. Kalau tak, nanti dia akan ada a bit weird, but that's a bit technical. But don't worry. Okay, next ni kita akan masuk a little bit of sustainable part, maksudnya a little bit of environmental design. You guys ready tak nak masuk sustainable design ni? Ke tak rasa ready lagi? Sebab kalau tak ready lagi, I can change kita punya direction towards something else, towards the modeling part. Sebab once kita sampai dekat sini, dia akan a bit, it's not susah, it's just way down the road sikit lah. What do you guys think?
Aku rasa boleh proceed je lah aku.
Proceed dengan analisis. Okay, proceed dengan analisis eh. Okay. Tapi I think before that, mungkin kita boleh try something. Maybe before that lah. Let's say before kita try something yang from our last class. Cuba korang tengah buka last class punya file lah.
Okay,
cuba buka last class punya file. Just pergi dekat Grasshopper ni and then tekan open document. And then buka document Grasshopper yang last tu. Okay, once korang dah buka. Okay, dapat tak file ni? Yang even kalau dapat yang buka yang file yang aku bagi tu pun dah cukup dah.
Okay, boleh.
Okay, pergi dekat this part. Ni yang from last class ni file eh. Dekat bawah ni ada satu group yang aku dah buat. Yang this one. Ada eh? Apa yang aku nak korang buat is copy ni everything from this and tekan Ctrl C and then buka balik yang file yang kita file baru tadi yang our recent class, latest class ni and then tekan Ctrl V kat sini. Dia akan copykan everything from file tadi pergi sini. Dapat tak?
Dapat.
Okay. Dapat eh? Okay, nice. Okay, apa yang kita akan buat sekarang is kita akan guna apa yang kita dah buat hari tu tapi kita akan apply dia to a surface yang kita dah buat tadi. Itu yang kita akan buat sekarang. Okay, apa yang korang perlu buat is just ambil yang daripada loft ni. Loft ni dia punya product dia is a surface tau. Kita dah dapat surface daripada loft ni. Ha, nampak dia tulis di nama dia untrimmed surface. Apa yang you guys just have to do, just connectkan L ni, loft ni pada surface. And then, just adjust all the numbers yang dekat dia punya value tu. Let's say lah U division ni, V division ni nak jadi lebih sikit kan. Sila 50. Okay, see? Apa yang, okay, berjaya tak?
Berjaya.
So apa yang you guys just did tadi, kita just use apa yang korang baru buat, yang apa yang korang dah buat last time. And then korang just apply a new surface yang kita baru buat tadi. Basically, ni dah in a way dah siap lah. In a way dah siap, maksudnya this could be you guys punya fasad dah lah maksudnya. It's a simple application je sebenarnya. Maksudnya, it's a matter of, in this case lah, in this process, it's just a matter of producing korang punya surface. Maksudnya, this is kita punya surface group tadi. Kita boleh produce dia punya surface yang kita nak. And then apa yang I just did tadi is copy yang daripada last class tadi is just about the panels kan. Apa yang panels tadi, kita just copy and then copy balik masuk sini and then connect the two dots and then terus jadi. So it's not that maksudnya it's takdelah, maksudnya you guys janganlah pening sangat. Jangan rasa pening sangat on this part. Sebenarnya this is very, it's quite simple. Especially bila benda tu is very easily transferable, easily boleh download and everything. And bila at this stage, let's say lah, kalau you guys nak try with something different dengan dia punya panel, just tukar this unit, just tukar this one to hexagon, to rectangle, to other panels, and then basically dia dah jadi lah. Tapi at the same time, you guys boleh tukar juga dia punya form tadi kan, dia punya form and shapes. Okay, so kita off dulu yang this one, off dulu yang panels ni, kita akan go towards to the, I want to introduce you guys dengan the form to the surface analysis dulu. Actually, what I've been teaching you guys ni is more or less is my thesis lah sebenarnya. My current thesis. This is the whole process yang I've been through untuk as the topic of my thesis. Tapi ada few things lagi at the end of the road yang I didn't show you guys, but all the essence sebenarnya dekat sini. And what I'm trying to say is this is a very basic application sebenarnya. So you guys ada banyak lagi room to explore based on this alone. Dia ada banyak lagi cara yang you guys boleh explore after this. Tak semestinya kena macam ni. But one of the common practices is this lah. So okay, let's start on the analysis. Okay, masing-masing dah ada ladybug eh tadi. Okay, apa yang I want you guys to first do to tekan is tekan ladybug on the canvas, ladybug PPW. Okay, dapat? Ladybug EPW. Ataupun lagi senang, just pergi dekat ladybug yang atas ni, dekat tab atas ni. The first thing yang you guys kena buat is tekan dekat ladybug punya menu. And then click on the first component tu. Nama dia ladybug underscore ladybug. Click and then place it. And just leave it there. Dia memang kena ada benda ni in order untuk ladybug to function. Okay. And then double click on the canvas, tekan open EPW file. Okay, yang this one. Ladybug open EPW weather file. Okay, dapat eh? Okay, sekarang ni kita nak attach a file. EPW ni is a file yang consists of all the weather data tau. Weather data from yang diorang dah already set up according to dia punya according to dia punya location. Maksudnya dekat KL ada satu EPW, dekat Singapore ada satu EPW, dekat London ada EPW yang berbeza. Dia ada data yang berbeza dalam tu. Then apa yang you guys have to do, the next one is tekan double click on the canvas, tekan boolean. Tekan boolean toggle. And then connectkan boolean toggle ni pada open. And then double click on the false. Okay, nanti dia akan keluarkan menu yang korang boleh search dekat korang punya browser, korang punya explorer. And then go for the file yang EPW yang I just send you guys pagi tadi. Dah download? Dia akan keluar sini. MOS Kuala Lumpur 486470iwec.epw. And then open. Okay, once dia dah open, daripada EPW file ni, terus connect pada disk yang tadi kita dah letak ni tadi. Okay. Apa yang korang just buat tadi, sekarang ni kita dah ada all the data, kalau tengok dekat sini, all the data yang kita perlukan in terms of surface, in terms of weather data dekat KL. Kalau you guys double click tekan panel, kita boleh then let's say connectkan latitude. Okay, tu latitude for KL. Kalau tengok location, okay dia dah bagi tu dah site location KL, longitude latitude berapa, elevation berapa. Let's say lah.
How do you open the file again?
Okay, double click on the canvas, tekan boolean. B-O-O L-E-A-N boolean toggle. Boolean toggle. And then double click on this false. Bukan double click lagi. Connect dulu pada open.
Okay.
Connect dia open. And then tekan double click on the false tu jadi true. Nanti dia akan buka pada explorer.
Alright.
Okay, and then select yang the EPW file.
But mine sends me to like online map lah.
Online map.
Is it the same?
Oh no. I think you select the wrong component. Make sure yang this one dia tulis open weather file, bukan download weather file.
Open weather file. Okay.
Boleh juga nak download. It's no problem. Cuma you just have to go online lah. But in this case sebab I dah bagi the EPW file, you don't have to go online lah.
Open weather file. Okay.
Ada?
Yeah, good. Okay.
Okay, got eh?
Okay, can proceed.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay, kalau tengok lagi dekat all this data ni, dia ada direct normal radiation, dia ada horizontal radiation, segala all kinds of environmental data yang you can use. Tapi I don't understand all of this pun. I just use a few stuff. But if you can, let's say lah, if you can exploit all the data yang kat sini, yang macam-macam lagi types of data ni, let's say wind speed. They say by knowing wind speed, you guys boleh control you guys punya facade. I don't know which how you can do that, but let's say lah, you guys boleh. Then this is the data yang you guys going to use lah. Let's say lah, by humidity alone, you guys boleh control korang punya facade behavior. And then dia dah ada data dia dekat sini. So apa yang kita akan buat next is kita akan set kita punya analysis punya parameter first. Okay, the next one yang I want you guys to use is kita akan create dia punya setting for the analysis. So apa yang you guys have to do right now is I want you guys to find this component. Nama dia, okay, tekan gen cumulative sky MTX. Okay, dapat? And then korang nampak dekat the first one tu, dia minta attachkan EPW file. Okay, then pergi balik dekat first dekat EPW file yang korang dah attach tadi, and then connect pada EPW file yang this one. So that kita dapat dia punya sky punya somehow like macam sky punya coverage. At this part actually, I can't really explain it to you betul-betul lah. Maybe you guys can, I don't know, maybe tanya later kalau ada kelas dengan Dr. Doris kan dekat environmental class, maybe you can boleh tanya minta Dr. Doris explain more on the technical environmental part. What I'm just trying to you guys for today is just apa setting yang you guys can use, which basically is dia punya preferable setting lah. Okay, and then for the sky density, kalau tengok dia ada terangkan apa, kenapa kena set to 0, kenapa set to 1, kenapa set to 2. For in this case, kita akan set to 0 saja. Sky density and then set to 0. And then nampak ni run it ni basically is run, nak run the component je sebenarnya. Dia bukannya run it in as a word. So just copy yang boolean toggle ni yang awal-awal ni, right click, control C, control V, double click supaya dia jadi true, and then connect pada run it. Dia can take some time sikit. Okay, mine is already done. Korang punya okay?
Okay.
The next one is this component, which is nama dia is select sky MTX. And select sky MTX. Okay, and then dari yang awal tadi, nampaknya ada cumulative sky MTX to the cumulative sky MTX connect kan? Basically, all the tricks yang you guys have to understand is kalau buat benda ni, kalau nampak dia punya output dengan input is the same, let's say the same, even the same typology, maksudnya dia the same. So ni kat sini nama dia cumulative sky MTX, kat sini pun nama dia cumulative sky MTX. Basically it meant to be the connected lah. Maksudnya kalau let's say you guys tengah explore kan, and then nampak benda yang sama, cuba try an error connect this few, all those benda-benda yang sama-sama tu, so, and that's to make it work. Just another tips. Okay, and then the next one is kita akan set dia punya analysis period. Maksudnya analysis period tu dari pukul berapa, dari tarikh berapa ke tarikh berapa. Okay, double click and then type analysis period. Oh, mana? Sekejap, dia tak keluar. Sorry, tak ya. Oh, just click type period, dia akan keluar ni. Okay, dari analysis period ni, okay, analysis period connect to the analysis period dekat select sky MTX ni. Okay, dekat this type, dekat this period ni, semua dah dapat ke period ni tadi?
Okay, dapat.
Eh? Okay,
dapat.
Cuba try this setting. Months, from months, tekan from 1. And then day, tekan 1 juga. From hour, let's say from 7, maksudnya 7 AM, to months, maksudnya ke bulan berapa, kita letak ke bulan 12. Today, maksudnya 31st, untuk dia punya total month, dia punya full day of the month. And then to hour is 19, which is pukul 7. So, apa yang this indicate is, you guys are doing analysis from dari pukul 7 sampai pukul 7 pagi, from 7 pagi to 7 petang for the whole year. Maksudnya the data tu akan being, dia akan total up to a whole year punya analysis. This is what this period of analysis ni represents lah. Sebab you guys boleh juga tukar this analysis to be, let's say, to monthly. Maksudnya kalau kita nak ikut seasons kan, let's say kalau kita nak buat on March, on June, on September and December, which boleh juga, tapi for the whole sum of it, kita akan buat as a whole year, so that dia akan generalize sikit. Sebab kadang-kadang the fact ya, the way sun's earth rotate around the sun tu can be different. Kadang-kadang sometimes dia akan lagi dekat, sometimes dia akan lagi jauh. But in this case, kita akan total up everything for the whole year so that kita lagi senang nak faham. Okay, once dah siap kat situ, okay, this is the main component untuk buat radiation analysis. Then type radiation analysis, ladybug radiation analysis, this one. Okay, I click and then select that one. And then okay, kalau tengok kat sini, select sky MTX ni, kita connect pada select sky MTX. Okay, kalau tengok this, kat atas ni ada tulis geometry. Geometry ni is where you guys akan inputkan korang punya surface tadi. Surface yang kita dah buat tadi. Kat sini is dia punya input. Tapi for now kita akan tak letak lagi. Kita akan set dulu. Pergi dekat boolean ni tadi. Copy this boolean. Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. And then connectkan dia pada these two, which is parallel dengan run it. Tapi kalau tak nak kalau tak nak di run lagi, you guys cuba double click, tekan dia jadi false dulu. And then connect pada parallel, and then connect pada run it. Okay, dapat? Okay, then click this one value, double click on the canvas, tulis 0.1. And then click connect to distance from base. Distance from base ni is just about the distance between the analysis punya surface to the original surface. So just kita nak just naik sikit dia, sebab kalau dia in the same, kalau dia at the same distance, nanti dia akan clash. So just naikkan sikit supaya kita boleh nampak yang berlalu aja. Okay, kalau nampak dekat radiation analysis ni, dia ada satu ni nama dia context. Okay, context ni is senang cerita is dia macam ni. Let's say lah in a crowded urban environment, you guys pilih satu site yang kiri kanan semua ada buildings. Let's say lah kiri kanan pun ada high rise tower. So this tower akan project shadows on you guys punya site, kan? So bila dia project shadows, means probably dekat surface of the new building yang you guys akan letak, ada certain surface yang akan ada less surface radiation disebabkan dia dah casted from the shadows from the building, existing building. So this is the context comes in lah. Maksudnya let's say korang ada satu site meshing model yang very simple, yang ada tower, ada banyak-banyaknya tower. You guys boleh load kan, pergi ke context ni so that dia boleh calculate sekali, dia boleh optimizekan lagi korang punya building surface radiation, sebab dia boleh tahu okay, this surface of the building tak kena banyak sangat sun radiation. Tapi for now kita tak buat tu lagi. Just okay, at this point kita dah cukup dah sebenarnya untuk the analysis. Apa yang you guys have to do is pergi dekat surface tadi, surface loft tadi yang kita dah siap tadi, this loft. And then connectkan dia pada geometry. Offkan loft. Okay. And then dekat boolean toggle ni yang ada false ni, double click on the false. Okay. Now kita dah dapat dah dia punya surface radiation. Tapi in a way dia akan seems a bit off lah. Dia sebab dia nampak kenapa banyak sangat biru kan. Macam pelik lah pula. Sebab padahal kalau ikutkan in real life kat sini semua memang dah akan dah akan expose to the sun. Tapi sorry, in terms of view ni, kalau korang perasan, nampak tak dia punya apa, legend ni macam hitam kan, macam tak betul, macam colour dia tak betul. Pergi dekat this perspective atas ni, click and then tekan rendered. This is the rendered views, yang yang rendered views of the whole model. Tapi kalau nampak, dia dah terrender sekali yang surface, yang facade yang kita buat hari tu kan. Kalau kalau you guys, the same thing happen to you lah. Pergi dekat preview yang hari tu, preview yang the facade tu, right click, off can render. And let's say kalau korang pergi to the top, tekan bawah ni, kita boleh tengok top view dia. Okay. And then tukar pada render juga. See? This is the value of the setiap panel yang dia dah calculate ni. Let's say lah dekat red tu, maksudnya dia ada 524,000.1.8 per meter square of radiation value. And then dia dah keluarkan dia punya analysis kat sini, berapa-berapa from 1 January 7 AM to 31st December 7 PM. So that's the info. This is the kinds of diagrams, environmental diagrams that you guys akan, yang you guys boleh produce later lah. Okay. Oh, tapi dah pukul 11 eh. Do you guys nak teruskan ke tak?
Habiskan ni, Min.
Habiskan ni eh?
Boleh.
Okay. Okay. Kalau korang perasan, the color of the biru ni dia macam pelik sikit sebab dia macam tak berapa, in a way dia macam tak berapa works on kita punya, apa yang kita cuba buat. Sebab let's say lah kita buat, let's say lah kalau kita buat facade kan, takkan this whole thing sama tiba-tiba dekat atas ni je yang lain. Dia tak berapa nak lawa. In this way sebenarnya this surface ni tadi, the way dia kira, the way dia analyze surface ni, it's a bit off. Sebab surface ni dia tak ada top tau. Dia tak ada atas dan bawah. Bila dia tak ada atas dan bawah, dia consider macam this surface, dia akan radiation analysis tu, dia hit on both surface. Maksudnya dia akan hit depan dan belakang sebab dia tak ada atas yang cover. Sebab kalau building, kita mesti akan ada, yelah, mesti, atas mesti lah tertutup kan. Bila atas tertutup, maknanya dia akan protect the other side untuk kena the sun from the other side. So apa yang you guys boleh buat sekarang is, dari surface ni tadi, oops, sorry, this one, dari loft ni tadi, double click and then tekan cap holes. Tekan cap and then connectkan loft ni pada cap. At this moment, offkan dulu yang analysis ni. Offkan the preview. Okay, sekarang ni kita dah off, kita dah letak cap dekat this form. Okay, cuba dari this cap ni, apa yang dari the result from this cap, korang right click dulu on the geometry and then loft ni disconnect and then click loft ni pada geometry. Okay, off can loft and then preview analysis. Okay. See? Sekarang dia dah lain sikit sebab dia punya scales of radiation ni dah berbeza sebab dia dah baca yang atas sekali ni, this top part ni akan make confirm paling panas. It's very sure dia akan panas sebab dia akan dia very horizontal surface kan. Horizontal surface tu dia akan terima lagi banyak radiation compared to the vertical surface. So let's say kalau preview on the render. Okay, now kita boleh nampak. Now range dia dah a bit, nampak a bit more logic. Tapi in this case kita tak berapa nak faham sangat dia punya panels tu punya division. Wah, apa yang you guys boleh buat is tekan dekat grasshopper, pergi display kat atas ni and then tekan preview mesh edges. There it is. So sekarang ni kita dah nampak setiap panel yang di analyze by this component. Okay, can you guys imagine kalau this is further down lagi lah. Setiap panel ni, setiap part segi ni tadi, kita boleh scale, kita boleh create, kita boleh adjust dia punya aperture. Tau aperture? Maksudnya dia punya openings. Openings to the, openings of each panel ni, dia boleh scale down according to the value of the sun radiation. Maksudnya, let's say lah dekat bawah ni, kalau nampak dia biru kan. Biru. Dekat sini, aperture dia akan terbuka paling besar sebab dia tak, dia akan terbuka paling besar sebab dia tak panas sangat. But at the same time, dekat atas ni, dia akan terbuka paling kecil sebab dia nak protect the most sebab dia paling panas. Boleh faham tak?
Boleh
faham eh? Okay. Are you guys still still up for it tak ni?
Boleh, dah
cukup? So far kalau kita nak stop dekat sini dah it's fine. Kita boleh proceed to later, the next stage later. So far ada apa-apa soalan yang nak tanya?
Aku ada satu soalan. Pasal radiation analysis tu.
Okay.
Untuk part context tu.
Okay.
Kan tadi kau cakap macam ada kalau ada building kat sebelah tu tinggi apa semua kan. That model tu has to be in grasshopper ke ataupun rhino ke ataupun kita orang buat dalam SketchUp dulu macam mana?
Tak semestinya. Let's say lah kalau macam, okay aku tunjuk kau macam mana kita boleh buat konteks tu tau. Sebenarnya kalau kau nak buat konteks tu dekat rhino pun boleh, kau nak buat konteks tu dekat grasshopper pun boleh. Let's say lah kita choose the simplest thing lah. Paling simple sekali kita buat kat rhino. Sebab basically rhino ni is the SketchUp lah. Dia basically just a SketchUp je. Kalau tengok dekat standard, and then click kat standard ni, kalau anda nampak this component box corner to height, kita nak, let's say lah kita create box kat sini indicating okay kat sini ada satu building dan kat sini ada satu building. Okay, tapi dekat bila kita buat model dekat rhino, dia tak akan connect directly dekat grasshopper tau. Sebab this is a physical je, dia tak ada apa-apa algorithm yang dikaitkan dengan rhino. Tapi kita boleh kaitkan dia, which is how. Okay, this is a bit macam ni. Kita kena represent dua model ni dalam grasshopper. Okay, the way yang kita boleh buat benda tu is double click on the grasshopper and then tekan B rep. Dia akan keluar this component. Okay, dia akan keluar this component. And then apa yang korang boleh buat is select dua benda ni. Select any solid yang korang dah buat tu. And then right click. Siap. Bukan macam tu. Dah double click on the B-Rap ni and then tekan set multiple B-Raps. And then select this dua ni and then tekan enter. So sekarang ni kita dah set this shape yang kita baru buat kat rhino tadi dekat grasshopper juga. And then kalau nak to be safe, kita nak make sure sebab korang kena faham tau, bila once ada benda yang korang set dekat grasshopper je, dia akan tapi macam mana sekarang, in order untuk make sure kerja korang lagi senang, apa yang korang boleh buat is right click on this B-Rap ni tadi yang korang dah set and then tekan internalize data. Apa yang internalize data ni buat, dia akan make sure dekat rhino ni kita dah tak perlu dah this two model. Sebab dia dah baca dah kita punya data tadi. So kita boleh delete je yang tadi tu. So dia dah ada data ni.
Dalam grasshopper tu lah.
Ha?
Dia dah masukkan data
dalam grasshopper. Sebenarnya dia boleh juga kalau kita nak buat dekat grasshopper, which is kita start je lah. Maksudnya start balik buat box, rectangle and then buat balik loft and everything. Tapi cara ni lagi cepat lah sebenarnya. Lagi cepat from buat dia daripada rhino and then connectkan dia pada grasshopper. Okay. Let's say lah sekarang ni korang dah ada ni kan. This is the context, the simplest context. Just connect je pada context. Nanti korang akan tengok dia punya behavior, dia punya radiation analysis ni akan berbeza. Okay. Mungkin tak nampak. Okay, let's say lah kita tengok dekat side mana. Okay, this side. Nampak? Let's say lah kalau I did the right click and then I disable benda ni. Nampak? This side dia akan terima more radiation. Tapi once dia ada context ni, dia dah, once context ni dah in place, see? Dia dah ada less radiation. So this is the things yang you guys have to consider masa korang pilih side. So do you guys nak site yang betul-betul like memang free of shadows? Maksudnya dia memang sangat-sangat panas, dia memang ada, dia sangat-sangat panas sampai maksudnya memang dia tak ada protection langsung from the context. Ataupun korang nak cari yang site yang macam sedang-sedang sikit, dia ada a little bit of shadows, ada a little bit of exposures, so that korang boleh ada, ada some dynamics lah in terms of korang punya setting kat situ. Tapi make sure jangan set site yang fully, site yang fully shadow lah, yang fully shaded, sebab nanti korang punya thesis akan, korang punya, korang punya topik akan, akan tak justified lah, sebab buat apa lagi nak buat fasad kan. So one of the things that you guys have to consider is benda tu lah. So okay?
Okay, okay, thank you.
Ada any other questions? Tanya-tanya jangan malu, don't worry.
Other than this honeybee kan, is there other stuff that you can use? Other analyzing,
analysis? Yeah. So far dia ada banyak, especially actually. Cuma ada certain analysis yang dia start, dia paid, dia kena, in order to you guys to dapat, dia kena paid. It's a paid service lah. The most common one is Ladybug. Just to explain the difference between Ladybug and Honeybee. Ladybug ni dia more towards the exterior punya setting, exterior punya analysis. Maksudnya dia ada sun radiation, dia ada surface radiation, dia ada sun position punya analysis. And then dia ada apa lagi yang penting kat sini? Dia ada all this weather data. Actually kalau you guys search dekat YouTube, dia akan tunjuk lagi macam mana cara kita nak guna radiation rose. Kita boleh tahu wind patterns. Kita boleh tengok macam mana wind patterns tu boleh connect dengan your building, boleh change your building. Banyak lagi lah sebenarnya. Yang surface radiation dengan sun position is very basic sebenarnya. Tapi what I'm just telling you apa yang I've already explored, sebab banyak lagi, sebab there's so many things yang unexplored tau. Tapi bila when it comes to honeybee dia more towards daylighting analysis. Maksudnya interior daylighting analysis. Macam Velux. Pernah buka Velux tak?
Tak pernah.
One of the options selain guna honeybee ni, sebab I've never guna honeybee lah honestly, sebab it's a bit dia a bit pening sikit. Dia macam another level of analysis yang you guys macam susah. Even I can't understand sampai sekarang pun nak guna honeybee. So what I did is I use Velux. Tu Cik Azhar dia cakap nanti korang akan belajar Velux dari PC kan. Tapi as long as you guys boleh stick to Ladybug, maksudnya let's say korang tak guna honeybee pun it's okay. Korang boleh stick to Ladybug and then try to explore more. Especially korang nampak ni kan, dekat environmental analysis ni dia ada sunlight hours, dia ada radiation analysis. Apa yang kita buat tadi is radiation analysis. Sunlight hours ni is about dia boleh kira each panel of the building tu dapat berapa banyak sunlight, berapa lama sunlight throughout the day ataupun throughout the year. Dia akan boleh project the same diagram, tapi dia punya value unit yang kita nak dapat tu is different lah. Maksudnya the in terms of period of time yang that surface is exposed. Maksudnya let's say lah, kalau nak predict kan, this semua surface ni could be exposed sebab basically dia tak ada apa-apa protection. Tapi kalau dia dah ada context tadi, maksudnya ada certain area yang akan less exposed. Tapi in this case, dia punya result dia is dia punya in terms of dia punya period of time benda tu exposed. So that's how it differs lah. It can be, boleh juga, apa lagi yang I've been using is ViewRose. ViewRose ni pun ada juga, which is dia boleh, kita boleh tahu, this is, dia bukan environmental sangat, dia more like towards the view. Maksudnya kalau istilah bila dah ada context, okay, site which angle yang akan produce the best view. For sure lah this one kan. So nanti dia akan ada satu ISOVIS yang akan nampak, this angle is the best, this angle is the best, this angle is the best. So that you guys boleh optimizekan benda tu lagi. More or less macam tu lah, tapi tak cukup. Tak mungkin, there's a very shallow explanation lah. And then you guys boleh visualize juga dia punya data dengan macam-macam cara lagi. In terms of dia punya, the way just the visualization lah. Maksudnya macam mana korang nak visualizekan benda ni. So that dia akan create a better diagrams. So far, this is the most basic yang I can introduce to you ah. Even I at this stage pun myself for my work pun I'm not going too far from this lagi. I'm trying to, tapi bila dia terlampau advance pun macam dia dah almost start to, dia dah a bit lari daripada topik. So you guys, up to you guys to explore sejauh mana you guys nak pergi on this ladybug. And but apa yang I've been teaching you guys hari ni is very, I should say it's quite easy, and it's easily applicable juga pada design later. That's it. Ada apa-apa lagi soalan?
Okay, lain tak ada eh. Rasa itu sajalah untuk sesi kali ni.
Okay.
Yang lain-lain tu macam biasalah kita explore.
Recording ada kan?
Recording akan upload as soon as possible lah. Okay. Soon.
Just something extra. In case you guys nak perlukan personal advice, yeah, you guys feel free to contact me. Kita boleh set up. Kita boleh set a video session. Even one to one pun if you guys need, I can show you apa lagi yang I can. Bukan, it's not like I know everything pun. Sebab benda ni sangat-sangat banyak. So at least kalau I tak tahu pun, I can show you where to go. Itulah. Just where to go. Apa yang, kat mana yang korang boleh search and kat mana yang korang boleh try to explore. Just in case kalau if you guys need something more lah. Sebab honestly, masa I start to do this, memang sorang-sorang lah basically. So it's a bit lonely road lah. Sebenarnya memang buat sorang-sorang. Tanya orang lain pun tak tahu. Tapi since I've already been there, so why not you guys utilize apa yang I know sekarang so that it's not going to be that hard on you guys. Just say.
Okay, thank you, Amin. Thank you.
Okay, sure.
Can we end this class, eh?
Okay, bye-bye. I'll show you guys dengan file ni, eh?
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye.
Amin.
Okay, welcome.